So hi and welcome to Buzzard Exploration. Today we're going down onto the beach at Saltwick Bay, which is just south of Whitby. Just going down a footpath that leads from the caravan park. It's a decent track that goes down. There's Saltwick Bay. It's actually turned out better than we thought weather-wise. As usual, we've got Mr. Coote with us. Mr. Coote's mother. So we're just heading down the path. And there should be at least one wreck down here, which is the Fred Everard, which was a fishing trawler, I believe. And there may be the remains, or part of the remains, of a hospital ship from the First World War called the Rohilla. There's also a lot of fossils down here. It's a good fossiling area and just very pleasant scenery. Hope you enjoy. All right. That's cool. There's a nice little headland there, or whatever you want to call it, where it's separated from the mainland. What do you call that? Promontory! Yeah. That's what's making all the noise. That little black and white bird there, you see him?
Yeah.
Oyster catchers. Thank you. top is just like water cascading down the cliff. Obviously water course from somewhere. Been doing it for years and undermining that rock. You can see it there, how all the vegetation's grown around it and all the minerals in the rocks. So hopefully we're going to get to see a shipwreck, and the shipwreck is in between that buttress or outcrop there and the edge of the cliff here. That's where the Fred Everard is. It's just a question of whether we can get down with the tide being in the position it is. So we shall see. In the cliff, the chalk and the iron and all the other minerals that are in it. And these slates underneath our feet. This will be where all the fossils are in this stuff, I would have thought. Jurassic clay. I think it's only just gone out, so or it's on its way out. Further than it looks, unfortunately. We never got to the wreck because the tide's too high. On the other side, just to see what this side's like. And we'll probably come back when the weather's better in spring and go over there to that side where the wreck is. Although there isn't a lot to see really. Mr. Cook's just had a swim. Yeah, it's quite a cool little bay. You can see the white line going through the cliff there. It's been a volcano that's erupted millions of years ago and left a line of fossilized ash. Well spotted, and I think that's going to be probably the best find of the day. Is it going in your rucksack, that? Is it can't go in mine?
Going
Coop's rucksack. Have you got a Coop?
No, I haven't. I'm not carrying that.
So we'll have a look, another look round and see if we can find anything else. People have obviously been chipping away at this, unless it's naturally fallen down. As you can see, it's been chipping away at it to try and get fossils out of it, by the look of it. The nodules, as you can see there, these nodules that are in it, that's what we've been after. There's one that's been broken out to try and get ammonites out of them. You can see all the nodules there and all the different layers, which is quite cool. So this is just like we just come down to see the lay of the land, just to see what sort of access there is, and we'll come down for low tide next time, because the parking's good, the footpath's good, and do some drone work. We won't be doing any drone work today, I don't think. We'll come and see the wreck and look for some fossils. I think Andrew's finding stuff. Yeah, it's a cool little bay. Just come across this, which is obviously a little memorial to somebody. Andy Ramsden, much loved, 20th of the 760 to the 1st of the 1st 15. Must have been a fossil, maybe. Hey, alright, Coopy? Are you alright?
I'm hungry.
Starving. You starving? Like Marvin? Starving like Marvin he is. Hey kid. Has he? But he didn't want to wee over there. He didn't want to pollute the sea. Yeah, I wouldn't mind walking to both of them.
Yeah.
Cool. Is that the footpath? Oh, that's the footpath there, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, we'll have to come back. Look how them birds are sat on top of that. So that was Saltwick Bay. We'll come back and have a better look at that. There's something there. Can you see something there stuck up?
Yeah.
That looks like shipwreck to me. See if I can take a photo.
Come on, Coop, you can do it.
Cooper, Cooper.
Nah.
Come on. Come on. Wild peas and carrots.
Good idea, Coop. Mr. Coop. Mr. Coop. Mr. Coop.
We go. That's the only problem with beaches here in on the east coast of Yorkshire. You've got to come down to them and you've got to go back up. The cliffs aren't exactly small. Apart from when you get south of Bridlington and it gets shallower. Thanks for watching, please subscribe, press the bell button for new notifications and give me a thumbs up. Oh, and check out the other people that I follow as well, some interesting stuff on there.